So. I want to move on, Carol. The Daily Express, Just Stop Oil. Your friends at Just Stop Oil.
Ah, yeah,
those appealing their sentences.
Yeah, the five that were slung in jail for Hallam was given 4 years. He's the leader of GSO, and the four were given 4 years each. And they're now moaning that they're too much. You know, let's just remind ourselves what those things on the M25, the chaos they caused. Cost the economy 765 grand. They met police more than 1.1 million. 50,000 hours of delays affecting traffic. More than 700,000 vehicles affected over 4 days of chaos. And they're now moaning that it was too much. You know, the thing, and do you remember there was that one of the protests...
No, lives were at risk, though, were they, Carol, with those protests?
I mean, I don't care.
If we compare them to what we've seen from the riots...
You cannot...
You may not care, but when it comes to sentencing, you do have to have some sort of scale there. Yeah. And if lives are at risk, surely that comes
at the
top.
OK, well, if you have a scale, how come up until these sentences, the scale was ludicrous on the side of leniency, where they'd get a smack on the wrist and they'd get 7 days in jail? It's not enough when you cause this kind of chaos. And, you know, they could have not only endangered themselves, they could not only have killed themselves up there. If one of them had fallen off, they could have fallen onto the motorway and killed a motorist
who was not expecting that.
You can't compare that.
But you have to. That's what sentences are.
Carol, that's why we have sentencing guidelines.
Yes.
And there has to be... Why are people saying...
And Christopher Hay here...
Well, this is now two-tier. This is two-tier.
No, it's not.
Let's bring Peg in. Peg, you've followed this process. We know you're a Green Party candidate at one point as well. I just wonder how you look at this sentencing and whether these appeals you think are going to be successful or even justified.
Well, I hope so. I mean, they've got good grounds because the judge didn't even allow them to put forward part of their defence, which was actually about the reality of what is happening with our climate. Let's just remember, though, that they were found guilty of conspiring. They weren't actually found guilty of doing it. They were found guilty of talking on a Zoom call. There were people throwing bricks at a mosque in Southport, and there were people who have been rioting and putting things on fire who have got lesser sentences than these lot who were talking about going onto a bridge to do something about climate change. You know, peaceful protest is completely different to people rioting. And absolutely, the people who've been rioting need to have the book thrown at them. But we've really got to, I think, rethink about what we do for peaceful protest, because it's the basis of a democratic society that people have the right to
peaceful protest. You cannot keep bringing major cities to a standstill, not just because of the cost, but and I go back to saying, you know, Peg says they weren't throwing bricks. However, they could have killed someone there. They could have killed themselves, or they could have killed someone.
That wasn't their intent.
I don't care if it was
their intent. Is not the same as setting fire to a building.
Consequences happen as a result of what you do. And the thing is, they were lucky in that situation. But, you know, I remember one of these people who was jailed for 4 years, a young girl called Cressida, her mother came out and said, she's going to miss her brother's wedding. Hello, how many people miss weddings on that motorway? How many people didn't get to hospital on time? How many people miss really important doctor's appointments because they were sat on a motorway for 5 hours because of these...
But all what you said, notwithstanding... Sorry, Peg, just one thing. All I'm saying is that the five have put in their appeals, and I'm sure the relatively lenient sentences compared to this given to the rioters will help bolster their appeal.
They're not, what do you mean relatively lenient? Yeah,
compared to this.
They're not lenient.
I'm just going to say, I think there is a genuine discussion to be had about whether Just Stop Oil always do have the right tactics for peaceful protests, and sometimes whether they are targeting the right targets with what they're doing. But, you know, Carol, you talk about disruption, you talk about inconvenience. You ain't seen nothing yet until we actually start to see the reality of climate change. And it has started already up here.
Do you really think people don't understand? Do you really think these people draw attention?
Worrying about getting to work on time is going to be nothing compared to dealing with
climate change. It's really patronising to assume that the rest of the population doesn't understand about climate change and that these idiots who throwing soup on works of art, do you really think that makes people's understanding of climate change clearer?
I agree with you. I think there are some questions. I didn't agree with them throwing soup on the work of art. You know, I think there are some questions about their tactics, and I started off by saying that we can discuss that. But we also need to have a proper discussion and a proper debate about what the reality of climate change is, and we do not have that.
We are having that discussion. Things are happening. How can you? You know, this is. You know, climate change is talked about every day of every week of our lives, and moves are being made to deal with it.
Climate change means we cannot do business as usual.
Okay.
That climate change means we have to change everything about how we structure everything. We don't talk about that.
Ed Miliband's latest announcement about building, you know, these wind things all over the country. People, we're doing stuff every single day to combat climate change. What they're doing, these silly antics, do not raise people's awareness. All it does is irritate people. That's all.
OK, we need to move on. Henry, it sounds ridiculous after talking about such serious subjects.